नमस्ते, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर के चौधरी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमन यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सिग्निफिकेंस और द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ फिनेंशियल एजुकेशन, द टॉपिक इन टू द एमएड थर्ड सेमेस्टर। फिनेंशियल एजुकेशन इज इंक्रीजिंगली इम्पोर्टेंट and not just for the investors, it is becoming essential for the average family trying to decide how to balance its budget, buy a home, fund the children education and ensure an income when the parent retire. Of course, people have always been responsible for managing their own finance on a day-to-day basis. Spend on a holiday, a save for new furniture, how much to push aside for a children's education or to set them up in the life. But recent developments have made financial education and awareness increasingly important for financial well-being. For one thing, the growing sophistication of financial market means consumers are not just choosing between interest rate on the two different bank loans or saving plans, but are rather being offered a variety of complex financial instruments for borrowing and saving with a large range of options. At the same time, the responsibility and risk for financial decision that will have a major impact on an individual's future life, notably pension, are being shifted increasingly to workers and away from government and employers. As life expectancy is increasing, the pension question is particularly important as individual will be enjoying longer period of retirement. Individuals will not be able to choose the right saving or investment for themselves and may be at risk of fraud if they are not financially literate. But if individuals do some financially educated, they will be more likely to save and to challenge financial service provider to develop product that truly respond to their need, and that should have positive effect on both investment level and economic growth. This policy, brief look at the importance of financial education and how the OECD is helping government achieve it. One key challenge is convincing people that they are not financially literate as they think they are.
Now the importance, the significance, individuals are increasingly being asked to take on sole responsibility and assume the burden of risk for complex saving tasks, which were previously at least shared with government or employers, such as investing for a pension or for higher education for their children. But how can individual worker or parents be expected to weigh the risk and make responsible choice in an ever more sophisticated financial market? This is true even in countries where consumers generally are familiar with financial instruments such as credit cards, mortgage loans and perhaps private saving to top up company pension plan. It is all the more difficult in emerging economies whose rapid development had given access to financial service to a large number of consumers, many of whom have only a limited experience with formal financial system. For emerging economy, the financial educated consumers can help ensure that the financial sector make an effective contribution to real economic growth and poverty reduction. But financial literacy is also crucial for more developed economies. To help ensure consumers save enough to provide an adequate income in retirement while avoiding high level of debt that might result in bankruptcy and foreclosure. The information available on consumer financial literacy is worrying for the two reasons. Not only do individuals generally lack an adequate financial background or understanding to navigate today's complex market, but unfortunately they also generally believe that they are far more financially literate than is really the case. This has become a cause for increasing concern for government for a number of reasons. For one thing, increasing use of credit card in OECD countries has led to an increase in personal bankruptcy. In 2003, almost 1 in 10 US households filed for bankruptcy, and number of private bankruptcy in Austria rose by 11%. And similar problems are arising in countries where credit is becoming more widespread. Korea has experienced large increase in consumer debt, while in Germany there has been increase in private insolvencies, at least partly due to increased availability of the credit. And for some people in OECD countries, the question of financial literacy is far more basic and boiled down to whether they have a bank account. Across the OECD, between 3% and 10% of population are without a bank account and are therefore financially isolated in a world where financial transactions, including payment of welfare benefits, are increasingly carried out electronically. So this is all about the importance of the financial education or significance of the financial education. Hope you understand the topic. If you have any query, please mention in the comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women University, Jaipur.